Hey, Dan.
Hey, mate. How are you?
I'm really well, mate.
Excellent.
We've got another Q&A session today.
We're back with another Q&A from Ben Thamba, 9725. Ben said, hey, Jake, could you please do a video on solar panel on roof for hot water with new homes? Just wondering if you leave the single panel whilst installing new solar panels, or can the solar hot water system run off the new solar panels?
Great.
So, yeah, he's talking about the solar boosted hot water integrated systems, which we've seen a couple of them.
We have, absolutely. Ben, thank you for your question. And that is actually a cracker question. Now, before we get started, I must admit my knowledge around solar hot water isn't as great as someone who would do it every single day. I have lived in a house that had solar hot water growing up my whole life. I've personally only installed maybe 10 or so, just the electrical side at that, right? Mm. But I do have quite a bit of knowledge around heat pumps and the new way that hot water should be done, in my opinion, in Australia. And I'd love to share that with you. So firstly, what we see with homes that were built in the 90s, 2000s, you know, even in the 80s, you see a lot of solar boosted hot water on roofs. They're all different types of technology. Some of them can be a solar panel, which is not normally what you see. Usually what you see is like a tube system where hot water's pumped up. It runs through tubes or something alike, manifolds, if you will, on a solar panel in a roof. It actually takes the heat out of the air and puts it into the hot water and puts it back into your tank. And it kind of just keeps pumping it through. And, you know, there are types of solar hot water that do that. And to be fair, that was a really, really good product in the 90s. Now, the challenge with that is it takes up always the hottest and best value real estate on your roof, being the north or the western roof. Now, we want to put PV on that roof. So we would like to remove as many of them as we possibly can. And here's why. If you're building a brand new home, I'd really, really suggest looking into hot water heat pumps. Hot water heat pumps, such as Reclaim, Ducks have them. There are a number of different brands that actually build these heat pumps. They are extremely efficient. Now, I want you to just forget about solar power for 1 second. Don't even worry about where the energy is coming for your hot water. The actual operation of a hot water heat pump compared to even just a standard electric hot water tank, it uses something like on average 7 times less energy per day to give your family hot water versus the standard electric tank. Now, how it does it is by it uses a CO2 refrigerant. That they are actually all quite different, but the one we've got experience in is Reclaim. So they've got a tank, like a normal, like a storage tank, be it 250 or 315 liters. Then it goes out to the actual compressor. Now that unit takes the ambient air temperature, puts it through the water, it heats the water, and then puts the water back into your tank. Now you can get a full tank of hot water using about 1 to 1.2 kilowatt hours of energy, which is absolutely nothing. These units also run really, really quiet. They take up pretty minimal space versus the standard electric tank, which quite commonly has a 2.4 kilowatt element, a 3.6, or even a 4.8. Now they are really, really big elements. They, you know, 4.8 kilowatts, you run that for an hour, you've just used 4.8 kilowatt hours, 4.8 times that of a heat pump. You're not even guaranteed that that's actually heated your whole tank, by the way.
Usually hasn't.
No, definitely not. So they are actually quite inefficient. Now, companies have come up with ways like a product called Catch Power, which is an Australian-made hot water diverter. Really, really clever product. It'll put your excess solar energy, so solar panels off a roof, forgetting about solar hot water altogether. It'll take that excess energy and it will actually put it inside your dumb electric tank and it will heat your hot water, seemingly from the sun. Now, again, that's a great stepping stone in the right direction. But if you're doing this from scratch, what we recommend is the smart heat pump that actually has a solar setting inbuilt into it. So the Reclaim unit, for example, you can tell that unit to only heat between 10 a.m. and 2 p.m., which is prime solar generating hours for most households. Now, the reason that's so important is because you've just heated your hot water from solar for free and you've used hardly any energy to do it. The most important part when it comes to doing any sort of storage tank hot water system versus solar boosted hot water is, instead of using the real estate on your roof for a solar boosted hot water system where that solar panel can only be dedicated to that hot water system, your PV system, can that energy can go anywhere. So if it's not time to heat your water, that exact real estate can be making you homegrown electrons, maybe to put into your car. You might be doing some cooking, or you might just be watching TV. So you're utilizing your roof space to work at all times rather than just putting that energy into your hot water. So I'm pretty against solar boosted hot water. I don't really think there's a great ROI case for them either. I really am a huge fan of, Reclaim or any other brand of heat pump. Yeah, absolutely. And that's what I have on my own house. And my next house, I'll definitely have another heat pump. They've been incredible. And, you know, if your heat pump runs out of hot water and you think, oh, maybe the tank's not big enough, you've literally got hot water in 20 minutes again.
Yep.
The recovery time on a heat pump is second to none. It feels instantaneous. Now, instantaneous is another one that we sort of haven't even touched on. I'm not really that familiar with electric instantaneous, to be honest. I don't know how reliable they are or the warranty periods, but I will tell you to stay away from gas instantaneous only because we've got to get gas out of houses. That's what we're here for, right? Don't start putting gas in houses and doing a gas instantaneous. Yes, you always have hot water, well, unless you run out of gas. And if you had bottled gas, you'd hate it because you run out all the time. But it's not the way to go. Hot water heat pumps are an incredible product, and I'd highly recommend looking into them.
Sure. So just getting back to the context of Ben's question, which I think where he's coming from, if I was to assume what he's saying here, is he says new homes. So as you know, with BASICS requirements, new homes have to pass BASICS. That's changing all the time, getting harder and harder. If I'm reading what he's saying here correctly, he's got a new build and it has a brand new electric boosted hot water system with the panels.
Okay.
So I think he's now trying to weigh up the, obviously it's got a whole life to live, this hot water system.
Yep.
It's probably in the prime real estate and he's looking at getting solar. So this is the very tough question he's coming from.
We're against landfill. We're against being wasteful too. If it's new and it's just been put up there and it's still in warranty, just leave it.
Yeah.
Put the panels elsewhere. Yeah. Buy yourself a good Enphase microinverter system so that one day when that hot water tank fails, you can get rid of the hot water off your roof. That real estate can now be used for solar because you bought an Enphase system. It's quite literally a matter of adding on two or three more panels with two or three more microinverters. Far more cost effective than doing a whole new string system, for example. Utilize that space as best you can, but don't go ripping it off for the sake of ripping it off if it's still got a great shelf life ahead. Because now that you've got it, it is actually not really the most expensive thing to run. It's not too bad. They do cost a lot up front to install,
though.
That's
right.
Yeah, quite heavy. But if you've already made that investment, play on, keep it on there. It's still far better than, you know, just an electric tank or any form of gas.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Thanks for your question, Ben.
Hey, Benny, thank you. Appreciate it.
Awesome.